in a London. See face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one. See face get around where I come from. Born and raised in a London. See face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one. See face get around where I come from. Born and raised in a London. See face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one. See face get around where I come from. Born and raised in a London. See face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one.
On my way to Coventry. Got my appointment today. I'll let you know how. When I get closer to the time, I'm going to be there well early. So I'm going to sit down and let you guys know my initial thoughts and feelings. And then afterwards, I'll let you know how it goes. But I'm in the underground and I do not miss London Underground. It's too hot. Flushes are not good. Jack, in a bit.
Cause everyone's phoning me, these man, they're moving like pagans. Look now, cause no one is owning me.
Born and raised in London. See face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one. See face get around where I come from. Born and raised in London. See face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one. See face get around where I come from.
From the south side of the city. Got a painting, yeah, you know, sticking with me. Tell her come right now and gimme. Girl, you drop it down low and gimme, gimme.
So when you get there, one time, you should be given a number by Lorimer, or one of his secretaries anyway. And you have to call that number to get in. If you live in London, it's pretty straightforward how to get in to London. If you don't, just head for Bond Street. And the quickest and easiest way to get to Bond Street. And it's pretty much it. But I'll show you now, anyway.
As you can see, we're here. And his office is on this street, Davies Street. I'm not too sure whereabouts on this street it is, but I know it's on this street. It's only a 2-minute walk. So I'm taking the exit from Bond Street. If you're not used to London, the train stations have many exits. So this one is going to take me out to Oxford Street. So it'll take me out across here. So we come out this way to Oxford Street, you're going to do a right out and a right. But obviously you've got different exits to train stations in London.
In a London, see face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one. See face get around where I come from. Born and raised in a London. See face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one. See face get around where I come from. Born and raised in a London. See face get around where I come from. See me not trust them, me love no one. See face get around where I come from. Born and raised in a London.
Worst food. All I want is food. But gotta do other things first. Put things into priority. Yeah, just got here. I personally came from Liverpool/Manchester the other day, and then today I'm just had to come from Epsom. So it was just Waterloo and then Bond Street. So took about an hour and a half to get here. Well, I was kind of like faffing around. I didn't go on one train straight to the other train. That's why it took that long. But yeah. But I'll fruit.
Hi.
Hey guys, you right? Do you want to tell us about your wonderful office today? Or your office? There's no office today. Normals. So guys, if you come to London, you come out of Bond Street, go straight, don't do a right, and come and buy everything from here. From these beautiful ladies.
Juice box.
Juice box. Have a good day, guys. I was saying, I'm losing my full train. I'm gonna come back to this in a bit when I get there. Hey guys, so I am actually outside Dr. Lorimer's office. It's a little bit, it's just a black door, and I'll show you what it is. It says 53 on it. It's on Davies Street. I've only got like 15 minutes till my appointment, so this is going to be quick. But obviously I saw Dr. Seal back in January. Today is now July 21st, I think. Yeah. So I saw him back in the end of January. And I was actually supposed to see Dr. Lorimer first, but I didn't do that. If you watch one of my past videos, I'll explain a little bit more. So Dr. Seal diagnosed me and did the assessment of gender dysphoria and said that I was good to start bridging hormones, so my treatment, my testosterone, as long as I made an appointment with Dr. Lorimer, which I did, and pretty much that. So I now have been on T for 5 months, and this second appointment is basically just because he needs a second referral, a second person to assess you, because they like to have two people, because at the moment my dose is only once a month, so it's less frequent than what it should be. So when I see Dr. Lorimer in a bit, hopefully the assessment is exactly the same as Dr. Seals, and he okays me to start my regular dose of testosterone and up it a bit, and yeah. My thoughts and feelings. I don't really have many. I think because I've already seen the first one, because I already saw Dr. Seal, I'm a little bit more. I was a lot worried and anxious about that. I'm still anxious about this one, but I kind of feel like I know what to expect more because I already saw Dr. Seal. So but I'll let you know how it goes after. And I'm slowly getting anxious now. So I'm gonna take some brief breaths and then I'm gonna go in. I don't really do appointments, I don't really like doing like this kind of stuff, so yeah, I'll show you the door now as well. Hey guys, what is up? So today I went and saw Dr. Lorimer in London, in Davies Street, just by Bond Street Station in London. So that was my second appointment. Now usually you go and see him first, and then you go and see Dr. Seal for a supporting evaluation and assessment. However, if you watch my previous videos about gender care and how I've done it, I forgot to book this appointment with Dr. Lorimer before I saw Dr. Seal. So I saw Dr. Seal in end of January. And Dr. Lorimer today, and today is the 21st of July. So he is such a nice, genuine person. He's very easy to talk to, first of all, and he makes you feel dead comfortable straight away. So I was a little bit nervous, tiny bit nervous beforehand, but not as much as I was my last one, and I think that's mainly just because once you've been to one, you get a genuine feel of how they're gonna go. Dr. Lorimer didn't ask as much in-depth questions as Dr. Seal did. I feel like Dr. Seal went a little bit more personal and kind of like touched on subjects in a way, in a more in-depth way, where it might make you feel a little bit dysphoric. Whereas Dr. Seal was a lot more, Dr. Lorimer was a lot more less like that. He still asked personal questions and stuff, but he was a lot. He never made me feel dysphoric at all throughout the whole thing. However, Dr. Seal, I felt a little bit dysphoric sometimes, having to talk about certain aspects. Maybe it's just the way he worded stuff, I'm not too sure. Both of them are nice, but no, Dr. Lorimer was really nice. But basically, he asked me a bunch of questions. What did he ask? He asked me about my childhood. He asks you about kind of like when you started feeling and finding that gender kind of stuff started coming into your life, when you started like obviously thinking about it. He asks you about any difficulties and stuff you had growing up. He asks you about obviously your sexuality and stuff to do with that, but he only like briefly touches on it. And then he asks you more like about like where do you feel, what parts did you feel were dysphoric, like what parts are your main dysphoria, what you want to get out of this session, like kind of like why are you there and stuff like that. My whole point of going to him was for a second assessment, so I can carry on my treatment, my HRT, and it was also I touched on top surgery with him. If any of you are worried
or concerned or are with gender care, and a little bit like, oh, who do I go to get certain documentations and stuff for certain things. I went and saw him today, and after today he is now going to give me a letter for me to change my gender marker, also for a passport, so he can do that. So if you need a letter to support the fact that you can change your gender marker, he can do that. He can also do letters for supporting evidence for top surgery or surgeries, so that's something he's doing for me. He can also do letters for example, my doctors was not letting me for the last 5 months inject myself, but every time I went to the doctors I had to pretty much tell the doctor how to do it because they didn't know. My GPs aren't very very useful. So he is doing me a letter to be able to do that. And also he looked at my testosterone results from now, from like the other week after I got my T-shot to the day before I got my T-shot, and from like a couple months ago, and he realised that the levels they're dropping too quickly. So like your peak levels, they're just dropping too quickly. So yeah, he's going to do that for me. And he's going to get that sorted and talk to Dr. Seal about that and get that raised up. So he is really good. He does talk and cover all the aspects that you need. I think anybody that's going with gender care, Dr. Lorimer and Dr. Seal, definitely a best bet. They are really nice. Obviously, they are both based in London. One's more North London, the other one's more Central. Me personally, I live in Liverpool, London, Liverpool, Manchester kind of way. But I do obviously live down south. I've got family down south, so it's a little easier for me to travel. But if you can make the travel arrangements, I'd definitely go with them. I know that Gender Care do have some other people based in different places. Like I think there's somebody based in Dr. Rachel, I think she's based in, I think, don't hold me to this, I think she's based in somewhere up north, like Birmingham. That could be wrong, I'm not too sure. It could be Leeds or somewhere, but I haven't used her, so that's why I've not really looked into it. But yeah, no, the appointment, great. So if you're ever worried, or if you're worried about who to go to in gender care, because I remember when I was first looking at gender care, I had no idea which person to choose, or, you know, there's all these different people, and I didn't really get who I had to go and see. And I definitely recommend Dr. Seal and Dr. Lorimer. If you see Dr. Seal, you have to see Dr. Lorimer. If you see Dr. Lorimer, you have to see Dr. Seal anyway. But them two are definitely your best bet. Their prices actually have just gone up. Luckily for me, when I booked, because I booked it quite a while ago, the prices were still at like a lower level. It's £220. But however, it's gone up a little bit, I think. I'm not too sure what it's gone up to. I think it's gone up to £250. But again, I'd have to double check. But yeah, so my thoughts after seeing him, I'm a lot more settled. I'm a lot more okay. I feel like, you know, taking the route of gender care was the right one, whereas before I saw him, where I'd only just seen Dr. Seal, and it had also just hit 5 months on T, I was a little bit wary of, hold up, I've had no interaction really, other than a letter telling me I need to get bloods done and they need to get sent back to Dr. Seal. So no, after seeing him, I'm a lot more confident as well about the whole thing. So yeah. Also guys, I'm going to leave his details all in the link just below. So if you do want to get in contact with him about anything, about potentially seeing him, whether that's for obviously a referral or a referral for surgery or to get on your T or so on, I'll leave all the links of gender care and him all down below in the description. But today was just really a catch up of what kind of happened. I went, the meeting's around about an hour and 20, but he makes you feel at home straight away, and he respects the fact that some people don't like talking about certain things. He used different terminologies like Shark Week, but yeah, it's been a good day overall. T's going well, my dose is going to be more frequent soon, and hopefully we'll get top surgery and stuff saving for and under the way. But yeah, anyway, ciao.